So you guys were one. I'm hearing all you guys. You guys wanted a theme song shortened, so here we go. This girl reviews movies, games, and books. Sometimes she plays them. So does that, and when she does it with the cat, does that make her crazy? Does that make her crazy? Probably. So, it's shorter. There you go. CrazyCatLady or Martha Butler does not own any trailers or pictures. I use them under fair educational for entertainment purposes.
Blade, it's like Sully did. Well, those years ago.
See?
No, I don't want to do any more of it!
Alright, hi everyone, Martha here. So the day we got one picture from season 2 of One Piece, and I guess it's covering season 2, season 3, and season 4 of the anime, because since it has Crocodile in it, and I saw like people join casting for Crocodile, and there's also a picture of I'm gonna show here of Chopper, just the back of him. Well, it's not really his front. Mostly, I'm worried about how they're gonna do with the his actual appearance. I mean, I saw all their people are actually making a good copy of it, a good what Chopper could look like. But I'm going by what images are gonna be on the show, and so far, all we see his antlers and his hat, and they're from behind. So it's not exactly the best picture, but for what we can see right here, it's fine. Let me see who plays. Is gonna play Crocodile, and I think Robin has been cast. So let's see. All right, this is who plays Crocodile and Robin. Well, I know in this show and during this beginning part, they're gonna be called Mr. Zero and All Miss Sunday. But we know if you've watched the show like I have been doing, they had two different names. So yeah. So the one who's playing Mr. Zero is Joe Manganiello. Hopefully I'm saying that right. And Lindell Mirandis is playing Miss All Sunday. Let me see what movies had they been in. Okay. He has been in the Magic Mike series. He was in Spider-Man. I don't remember who he played in Spider-Man, but okay. True Blood. I did watch True Blood a long time ago. Let's see. Trying to see anything I watched. He's in Spider-Man 3, too? I don't remember him! I can't see anything that I actually remember that watching that he was in. Alright, let's try the other, the girl. Okay, I don't know these movies. But hopefully they do a good job as, their roles. And I don't know if they're keeping the same voice actor for Chopper from the TV show, from the anime, but they could. And that's only news that I would have to talk about right now for the show. If I have time after I'm done talking about it, I will add a trailer for Wednesday and a clip of we have of season 2 of Avatar live action. So this season of One Piece season 5 did not have that many did not talk about one story in particular, like the past other seasons. It kind of reminded me a little bit of season 1, because how much traveling they did in this one, and they only had like two main stories where they stayed in one spot. Like the first 5 episodes were like each one of the characters got their own story. Like Sanji, I don't remember Nami's story, but I remember Sanji, he taught a marine kid how to cook. We got a backstory of Zoro when he meets Johnny. The guys who call him Zoro, call him Big Brother. And then we get like a story where Chopper treats a guy named Zenny, who's old and living on an island that the Marines chase the crew to. And he has Zenny has a bunch of goats, and he was gonna be buried inside of like have his grave be his ship, but eventually he like decided to go on sea with the nothing but a bunch of goats being his crew. But we know this show's weird, so why would that not be weird? And Usa helped a kid who wanted to build fireworks. And after that, we have a story that sort of kind of reminds you of Peter Pan. So they go to a town where there's a bunch of where there's a professor guy who's being blamed for the mayor charging people a bunch of weird taxes. The mayor was an old pirate, and his name is Weldon. Weldon, it looks like it's spelled, but it's spelled different. Wait, it's spelled weird. But anyway, he came Mary Cut. If you know Captain Morgan's story, he came a general. So it kind of reminds you of that story. Even though mayor is not the same thing as general. But yeah, it's not the first time a pirate went from pirateer to. But he still, this guy, Weldon, kept his, pirate stoke us out. Fact that he charges everybody and ate a lot of berries. And they go to the city and they meet the professor, who's trying to get into the Rainbow Mist because of his friends are in there. And he wants to save them. So he joins Weldon, even though he's the one that got them in there in the first place. And he got left behind because he tackled the captain, and they both went in the water. And when they get into the Rainbow Mist, which is, the professor goes with Luffy, Usa, Robin, and Zoro. But Zoro is asleep because it's Zoro. And when they get in there, they find them, and they notice that none of the kids have aged, while their friend, the professor, is like in his 50s. Well, they're all the same age, so that's how this is kind of like Peter Pan, because since they never aged. It's also kind of reminds you a little bit of Hook, too, because he comes back to them, he's aged old up. But there's Marines that were chasing them over here, that with a guy where he would use a coin and aim at it, then it would break stuff. And they still show that Marine later on that was helping Nami when she gets in there. Sanji and Chopper never go inside the mist. Because Nami heard that there was treasure over there. She goes and gets it. And when they get out after Yuffie and their leader, who I guess you can say is like the Peter of this. He's the leader captain of the Pumpkin Pirates. He ends up talking to him, making him, leave the fact that they're gonna get out of the mist. And then they end up, they have a cap, one of the pirates that were, Weldon's, crew members go in the mist with them, and he tried to take over the crew by tricking the kids, but the captain of the Pumpkin Pirates outsmarted him and put him in jail. Robin Nui, I think his name is, okay. And after that, they end up getting out of there by blowing up the ship that the kids came in. And the kids all go back to help them blow up the ship so they can blow over there. And Weldon's grandkid and son are on there with the carrot from Yuffie's crew because Weldon betrayed them in order to get the treasure owed to himself because you want to be selfish that they find in there. And when they blow out, we were thinking, do the kids come back? And we find out the Marines that were chasing Luffy here is actually Robin Nui, all grown up. And there were, and then the other kids all grown up too, and they're now the same age as the professor. Now the Marines, because they wanted to arrest the Weldon, because then when they got taken out, they were taken back to the time period that they came out of, so they actually all aged all up. So, but it's kind of weird that we meet Robin Nui as an adult before all this happened. Like, this is a really weird time travel thing. So yeah, it was a cool twist. I did like that. So let's watch the two trailers and see on here. Okay, ready? Let's go, Nala. Is that Toph's feet? Because she can't wear shoes with her power. That's how her earthbending works. She sees with her feet.
Yay! They want to see her whole body, though! What is with them that's showing certain parts of the body? First you see Chopper's back of his hat and his antlers, now we see just Top's feet!
Okay, let me get Wednesday's up.
Hello, my little storm cloud.
Let's play dolls.
I don't like Wednesday, she's scary!
Season 2 of Wednesday.
This
season is going to be bigger and more twisted than you can ever imagine.
Okay.
Bye-bye, guys!
If we showed you any more, your eyes would bleed. I'm not that generous.
I know you're not. So I think that's just a behind the scenes thing that happened that's going on right now. So can't snap. There we go. Anyway, I can't wait for both that stuff. Now let's rate this one. I still think I liked the season before this a little bit better of One Piece, because the villain in this season's kind of unforgettable. Because I had to look it up, and I just really wish that they had him around longer. But we'll see what happens in season 6 of One Piece. And I can't wait for all these little clips that I showed you guys of news, future shows, and shows going further on in their lifetime. So I'll see you guys later. Like, favorite, and subscribe. So let me think. I'm gonna give this season I'll do a 6 out of 10. So yeah, because I did like some of the episodes. I did like Zoro's episode and Sanji's episode. I did like the fact that they kind of did remind me a little bit of Peter Pan and Hook. But yeah, but not very much. So I'll see you guys later. Like, favorite, and subscribe. And goodbye.